Magandang araw sa inyong lahat. Ako ang teacher niyo ngayon. Ako si Sir Gilbert Paradero. Welcome sa Disciplines and Ideas in Social Sciences o mas kilala as DISS. Last time na talakay natin ang anthropology and sociology. In addition to that, the etymology or origin of words of anthropology comes from the New Latin anthropologia, derived from the combined words anthropos, which means human, and logos, which means study. At sa sociology naman, is derived from the Latin word socius, which means companion, and the Greek word logos, which means study. So nakikilala niyo ba to? Hindi si Bong Revilla ang pag-aaralan natin ngayon, ha? Ang political science ay nanggaling sa Greek word polis, na ang ibig sabihin ay city-state, at Latin word na sire, meaning science or to know. Kaya sa madaling salita, ang political science is the study of the city-state. Pero, mayroong mas malino na pagpapakahulugan sa mga political scientists. They define it as a social science dealing with the systematic study of the state in its essential nature, form, manifestation, organization, and development. Sa historical background, kung itetrace back natin ang history, nagsimula ito kay Aristotle, who is considered the father of political science. At ito rin ang sinasabi mo kapag gusto mong palisin ang pagong. Aristotle. Back to the story, si Aristotle ang isa sa nagbigay ng kahulugan ng political science, and he believed that it was a powerful branch of science and that it held special authority over other branches, such as military science. Pero bago pa man nagsimula ang mag-aral about politics, sina Aristotle and Plato, nababanggit na ni Homer sa kanyang poet ang politics. At nabanggit na rin ito ng mga kilalang historian tulad ni Herodotus at Thucydides. Meron tayo iba't ibang branches ng political science. Sa narito, yung political theory. It is the study of theories and doctrines on the origin, form, behavior, and purposes of the state and government. It is also called political philosophy. Pangalawa, public law. The field of political science focuses on the study of legal rules and principles governing states, governments, and individuals as they are related to one another. Pangatlo, government. The field studies the structure and function of both national and local governments within the context of one state or country. Comparative government. This field focuses on analyzing the similarities and differences among states relative to their executive, legislative, and judicial branches of government, as well as their fundamental laws, functions, political cultures, and traditions. Internal relations. It is study of foreign policies of countries, international organizations, and international law. Public administration. It deals with the actual management of the government in the realms of administrative organization, personnel, and human resource management, fiscal management, and management of public relations. Public policy. It is concerned with assessment and evaluation of the various policies pursued by the government in areas like education, defense, and health. Political dynamics. This field is critical inquiry into the various societal forces that exert influence on political decision and action. Government and business looks into the government's exercise of corporate or business function as well as its regulatory function that affects the economy of the state. It is also called political economy. Legislature. It focuses on the essential role played by the lawmaking body in rule making, as well as the politics behind the legislation. Geopolitics. It delves on critically analyzing the influences of population, resources, and the physical environment of a country on its local international politics. What are the values and uses of political science? Number one, awareness of the importance and impact of government on people's lives. Number two, education for citizenship. Number three, development of civic values. And number four, a preparation for various careers and professions. So, ano nga ba economics? Ang etymology ng economics o origin ng salita ng economics is derived from the Greek word oikonomia, which means household management. Economics was the first to read in ancient Greece. Aristotle, the Greek philosopher, termed economics as a science of household management. But with the change of time and progress of civilization, the economic condition of man changes, resulting in an evolutionary change in the definition of economics. So sa malinaw na pananaw, binanggit ni Aristotle na ito ay household management. Hindi na lang ito umiikot sa household management. Habang tumatagal ang panahon, nagbabago ang definition ng economics, lalo na ng panahon ng 18th century, kung saan kinikilala natin si Adam Smith as the father of economics, defined economics as the science of wealth. And according to him, economics is a science that inquires into the nature and causes of the wealth of nations. Ulitin natin ha. Ayon kay Adam Smith, economics defined as the science of wealth. At ayon naman kay Aristotle, it means household management. Sino nga ulit ang kinikilalang father of economics? Okay, si Adam Smith. At ayon naman kay Alfred Marshall, economics defined as the study of mankind in the ordinary business of life. At ayon naman sa modern economist na si Lionel Robbins, he defined economics as a science which studies human behavior as a relationship between ends and scarce means which have alternative uses. Therefore, economics as a social science discipline studies how people perform economic activities and how they try to satisfy unlimited wants by the proper use of limited resources. Naniniwala ba kayo na unlimited ang wants ng isang tao? Okay, may dalawa tayong branches ng economics, which is napag-aralan nyo na to nung grade 9 sa subject din na economics. Isa na dito yung microeconomics. Microeconomics examines how entities forming a market structure interact with the market to create a market system. These entities include private and public players with various classifications, typically operating under scarcity of tradable units and light government regulations. Sa macroeconomics naman, it examines the economy as a whole to explain broad aggregates and their interactions top-down. That is, using a simplified form, general equilibrium theory. Paano naman ang nagsimula ang history? History comes from the Greek word historia, meaning inquiry, knowledge acquired by investigation. If we simplify, history is the study of the past. Events occurring before the invention of writing system are considered pre-history. History is the umbrella term that relates to past events as well as the memory, discovery, collection, organization, presentation, and interpretation of information about these events. Persons who focus on history are called historians, and Herodotus is considered to be the father of history.